Hey, what's going on, guys? It's the Yankee Fan. What I'm coming to you guys with today is episode number 19 of my Baltimore Orioles franchise here on MLB 14, the show. So last episode, we started off the next season, and we started off a little poorly. We lost our first game, and then all of a sudden, we just really got on a big losing streak. We were like 13-10 at one point, and it was just a very bad time. So hopefully we can turn that around now. I believe our record is 11-15, something like that. So we're not too far out of the mix of at least having a decent record. So let's see if we can get back on track here in this game against the Yankees. Now, when I was playing this game, the Yankees literally lost all of their stars, besides like their outfield, Jacoby Ellsbury and Carlos Beltran. I think that's really it. Maybe Brett Gardner, and that's it. I don't understand what happened. I know Derek Jeter retired. I don't know what happened to Mark Teixeira. I don't know what happened to Alex Rodriguez. I don't know what happened to Brian McCann. I don't even think Brian McCann was in this game either. It was just weird. I don't know what happened. But anyway, let's get into this game now. Bottom of the first inning, we got Nick Markakis up to bat. Before we even talk about this gameplay, though, I do want to apologize to you guys. I know I told you guys that, don't worry, the sports videos are coming out. Don't worry. And I'm sticking to my words. I'm going to have these sports videos staying consistent for you guys. But I was supposed to post this MLB The Show video on Thursday, and I just did not have any time. Not that I didn't have time, but I really was just grinding Advanced Warfare recently. You guys probably noticed with all the videos that I've been posting nonstop Call of Duty videos. And I do apologize, you guys. So that's not going to happen again. I'm going to hopefully make sure I'm staying on track, getting my MLB The Show and the Madden videos up to date as well. So don't worry about that, guys. I'm not quitting these sports series. I'm just posting a lot more Call of Duty right now since that new game did just come out. So anyway, let's get into this game. Once again, now you see Manny Machado is going to tie up the score with a solo home run here. I believe it's in the bottom of the second inning. That's a big home run right there because, you know, last game we really just did not play well at all. We could not get these big offensive hits. So hopefully that can turn it all around right here. We'll have to see what happens, though, coming up in the next couple of innings. So now we got a tie score as Manny Machado crosses home plate. Scores is 1-1 now. We're going to move ahead to the top of the third inning, I should say. And we got Wee and Chen on the mound for us today. There's going to be a ground ball to shortstop. That's going to be J.J. Hardy throwing it onto first base. That's going to be in time. And it looks like we have Wee and Chen settling down. You saw in that first inning, while I was talking about some other random nonsense, they did end up getting a 1-0 lead. We did tie the score, though, so the score is now 1-1. That's going to be Adam Jones with a base hit into right field. That I don't know how that got past the second baseman. Like I said, though, they have a bunch. I think that's like Francisco Cervelli playing first base. I don't even know. I think that maybe Scott Sizemore playing second base. I don't even know. Like, these players are not like MLB stars, so I don't think that the Yankees in this season are going to do anything. So we'll have to see if we can take advantage of that since they are one of our division rivals. We got Nick Markakis up to bat now into the bottom of the third inning. Full count. Here comes the pitch. That ball's going to be driven into left field. Going back is that left fielder. I believe that's Brett Gardner. I don't even know. But that ball is going to get out of here. It's going to be a two-run home run for the Orioles as we're going to jump ahead to a 3-0 lead now. And like I said, though, the Yankees, I don't even know who that left fielder was. I think it's Brett Gardner, but I don't know. They either traded away their players, they're injured, or they retired. I don't know what happened, but there's not a lot of Yankees on this roster right now that I really know in real life. So anyway, we're going to move ahead. Once again, top of the fourth inning, Wee and Chen is on the mound. Don't know who this batter is once again, but here comes the pitch. That's going to be flat out into left field. That's going to be Nelson Cruz going to settle underneath that one and make the catch. So Wee and Chen, after having a all right first inning, he was kind of shaky. He has started to settle down now in this game. So Alfonso Soriano, another guy I did not tell you guys that we ended up signing in the offseason. I forgot to mention his name. We're going to have him coming up to bat now, and this is one of our main signings in the offseason besides Max Scherzer. So we'll have to see what happens, though. So here comes the pitch. That ball's going to be driven deep into right center field. Going back is the center fielder, Jacoby Ellsbury. That's going to be off the wall. That's going to be a base hit. The runner's rounding third base. He's on his way home. Here comes the throw. It is not in time, and the Orioles are going to jump out once again to a 4-1 lead. Alfonso Soriano is getting a big hit right there as that was off the wall. So we're anyway into the bottom of the fourth inning still. Runner on second base. Here comes the pitch. Jamile Weeks is going to drive that one into right field. That ball is going to get out of here. A home run, a two-run home run for Jamile Weeks and the Orioles offense. Finally, we're having an offensive outburst. It's been a while since we had an offensive outburst, to be honest with you guys. I don't know what our problem was recently, but we just have not been hitting the ball well. And that home run really, this game so far, with the score being 6-1, it's really a good feeling because of the fact that we've been struggling a lot. You saw in the wild card game, I think we did score a lot in the wild card game, but our pitching staff was just awful. So it's good to see that our hitting and our pitching is also doing well. And as soon as I say that, that's going to be a home run for the Yankees. I believe that was going to be Scott Sizemore, who is going to hit a home run. And that's a little unfortunate. Bad timing on my part saying that our pitching is going to actually be doing well once we give up a home run. But the score is still 6-2, so we have a 4-run lead still. As long as Wei and Chen can try to bounce back from that, I think we should be all right. We're into the top of the 7th inning now. 2 outs. 1-2 is the count. Here comes a pitch. Ground ball. J.J. Hardy's going to fail that one. Throw it onto first base and white over Chris Davis's head. Come on, Chris. Oh, my goodness. Now we're starting to collapse right now. Come on, like, we got it. The Orioles got to bring it together right now, and we got to try to at least get an out so they don't score any more runs. We cannot let the Yankees capitalize on us. So here we go. Runner on second base. Here comes a pitch. That's going to be flied out into left field. That is deep. Going back is Nelson Cruz. He will settle underneath that one right in front of the warning track, though. So we do escape some. We do get out of that, though. It looked like we were going to give up a couple more runs that inning, but thankfully we don't. So Nick Markakis in the next inning. He's going to hit that one into right center field. That's going to split the outfielders, roll all the way to the wall. Adam Jones is rounding third. He's on his way home. No throw at all, and that's going to be an RBI double for Nick Markakis, and we're going to jump out once again to a 7. I believe it's actually going to be an 8-2 lead now for the Orioles, so we're looking good. Let's see if we can keep it up. Matt Wieters in the bottom of the 8th inning. He's going to hit a ground ball right up the middle. That's going to be a base hit, so our offense continues to swing the bat really well in this game, and that's exactly what we need right now. We needed our offense to hit well, and we needed our pitching staff to finally actually give up less runs than 5 in a game, so we're looking good so far. Manny Machado is the next batter for us. Here comes the pitch. That ball is going to be driven deep into center field. Going back is the center fielder, Jacoby Ellsbury. He is on the track. That ball is going to get out of here. Second home run of the game for Manny Machado. And the offense for the Orioles. The swing and nose, as somebody, one of my subscribers said, I believe that was Rob the Yankee. He says that all the time. The swing and nose are back at it in this game. So let's see if we can keep it up. And it looks like we are going to go ahead and win this game, but we'll have to see what happens. So as long as our pitching staff can help us. The score is 10-2. Into the top of the 9th inning, that's going to be Andrew Bailey on to finish this one off for us. Strike 3 right there as Scott Sizemore is going to strike out swinging right there. So we are down to our final out. Let's see if we can get it done. Let's see if we can defeat the Yankees. The score is 10-2. Top of the 9th inning. Here comes the pitch. Ground ball. J.J. Hardy is going to field that one. Throw it onto first base. In time, ball game over. The Orioles are going to win this game by a final score of 10-2. Big pitching game by Wei and Chen, as you see him right there celebrating with his teammates. Definitely a much-needed game that we needed. We needed an offensive outburst to try to get some kind of momentum going for our team. We needed to get a win on the board, and hopefully that will help us out later on in this series. So we'll have to see what happens. Though, let's take a look at the final box score. 10-2 is the final score. Seven hits for the Yankees, 13 hits for us. Well, we had 3 errors on the game. That's not going to win us many games, so we have to try to fix that coming up soon. But anyway, we're going to simulate some games now. Let's see what we got going on here. We're going to defeat it looks like we're actually losing a lot of games right now, but we'll see what happens, though. We're going to simulate a game against the Indians. We're going to win that one, and it looks like we're going to sweep the Indians, so we needed that. And we're going to end up this video going up against the Tampa Bay Rays next episode. We are 22-21. I mean, it's not too bad. We are at least over 500 right now, but you see, we need to start to capitalize a little bit more. Jesus Montero just has not been playing well at all, so we're actually going to substitute him out of the lineup now. So hope you guys did enjoy the video. If you did, make sure that you drop a like, and if you're new to the channel, make sure you subscribe. If you guys want to see the comment of the game come back, return to this series, definitely try to comment something down for the comment of the game. I do want to bring that back, but if you guys aren't going to comment down below, I'm not going to be able to do that. So anyway, I'll see you guys next time. Have a good day, guys. Peace.